guys, thanks for tuning in. I'm about ready to change the brake cylinder on my RV. It's a 1988 Jamboree Fleetwood, and the brakes have been leaking a little bit, so it's time for the brake cylinder to change out. You're gonna see me pop out the tires, the drum kit, and change out a couple of springs in there. So keep following along, I'll show you how that goes.
So it hasn't snowed in Charleston in 7 years. That's crazy.
That's crazy.
That's crazy. This is the dog's what, second time seeing snow now?
Well,
the puppies.
They were born in the snow.
They were born in the snow, that's true. But this is their second time seeing it.
Yep. It's covered in paint.
This is crazy. How much snow is here? This is insane. I don't think we're even gonna find a ball. Yeah, forget about the ball. You found one? Oh, Junior got one.
Now I want to see them find that.
I know, right?
Where'd it go?
Nobody knows.
It went over the fence?
It went over the fence?
How did you throw it that far?
I didn't even see it.
Eternity later.
And I thought you were ready to give up.
It's important for me to learn all this stuff through experience. That way, if anything happens on the road, any mishaps, I've already told myself, or I know that I've done this before. I've removed the wheel bearings. I've removed the, you know, whatever I need to get underneath in case a flat happens or anything. I can do it right on the road because I've done it before. I'm doing it right now. I'm taking all this in, and I'm just showing you what I'm going through. So it's one way to learn, that's for sure.
So this guy right here, it's hidden behind this guy. That's the wheel cylinder. We have to get this thing out. You can see that. So this is the wheel cylinder right here. If you go behind that, you want to spray that with PB Blaster just to make it easier to remove the bolts and not to strip it out. Because that's the last thing you want to do, is start stripping bolts out.
Thank you. Okay, I then realized my camera was off for the past 45 minutes, so I've missed somewhat of my uninstallation. I've removed some springs from the drum kit. I just showed you how to remove the screws from behind a brake cylinder, and that's this little guy right here. I still gotta pop it open. But yet, I got some of the springs off from behind. Just take pictures of it, remember what it looks like, and when you're installing it again, it's gonna help a lot using those pictures as reference. Well, here's the new wheel cylinder. It already has the bleeding valve right on there, so no need to use the old one. The pistons you still need to use though, so I've grinded off some of the rust that was in there already. So I'm just gonna pop them in the new cylinder here. Okay, here was my first mistake. So this spindle lock, it's not lefty loosey. I was doing left to unlock it, or to spin it out, and it wasn't coming out. I figured, damn, this thing's really stuck on there. I think I even shaved off a couple of the notches in there, but that's all right. So this was 3 hours ago. I'm like, damn, that lock is in there pretty good. So I gave up on that, and I just started working on the wheel cylinder and all the little springs in there. And I go back to the 3 hours later, I go to lunch, I go grab something to eat. I come back and this spindle lock still has me stumped. So then I just gave up on it and I'm like, okay, I'm just gonna tighten it down. So I start tightening it down, righty tighty. Found out it wasn't righty tighty, it was righty loosey. So I was spinning it the wrong way this whole time. So I was, kind of a pain in the ass working on the springs in the wheel cylinder with this ginormous thing in the way, but I figured out how to remove the spindle lock now. So I'm gonna remove the lock, I'm gonna get to the bearing in there, I'm gonna grease up the bearing and then put everything back in. Thing's heavy. Good morning. It is the next day. We are off to a little bit of a colder start. It's kind of tough for me to finish these things, these bigger projects, because I just have so much going on. But anyway, let's continue on with the repair. Okay, here's all the replacement springs. You can see all the nice little colors looking nice on it. Use the same pistons that were on the older ones. You just take them out, clean them up a little bit, clean some of the rust off a little bit, puts a little bit of grease, and then just pop them inside these and just pop the whole thing back in. And then you can see I added some grease where the brake pads touch. And then all I did was put the springs back where they came from. Take pictures because you're gonna forget. Tricky to get back in because it sort of bends upwards. Okay. Took me a minute. that's it for me, guys. I am extremely exhausted. I worked for the past 8 hours straight working on these breaks. I did both sides. I'd only filmed one side, but I'm completely finished. The only way for me to torque the bolts that go into the drum was to stand on it. So I'm standing on the big bar, you know, the breaker bar that torques it in. I do have a torque wrench, by the way, so I did do it right. But I was tightening it up with the breaker bar, and you know the only way to get force on it is to stand on the thing. So I stood on it and slipped off it, and the whole thing swung around and slammed me in my ankle. So now my ankle is bruised up. It hurts to walk on it. It's swollen right now. Let me show you what I'm working with. I'm gonna try my best to get this on camera, but it's swollen right here. You could see how this is the normal one. This is the swollen one. You see it hurts right over here, this area. Yeah, it hurts. I'm gonna put some Vicks on it, because Vicks fixes everything, according to my mom. So I do have it. So I'll catch you guys on the next video.
He doesn't know what to do.
Yeah.
Like, are you confused?
I saw you throw a ball, but
eat some ice.
Ball's gone.
Is it?